don't believe in depression. Don't message me about depression because I don't believe it. If you're asleep in your bed in the middle of the night and you hear a noise and you believe in ghosts, now you're afraid. But if you don't believe in ghosts, it's the wind and you go back to sleep. You give the ghosts power by believing in them. Your house is only haunted if you believe in ghosts. Belief is a powerful thing. If I were to stand in front of you and I were to tell you that I could punch you as hard as I can in your sternum and I could fracture it and send a splinter into your heart, would you allow me to try? You wouldn't, because you know I believe I can. I believe I can hurt any man on the planet, and that's why people are afraid of me. And you believe depression is a crippling disease, and that's why you're afraid of it.
So me and my brother were walking down Chisinau, Moldova. It's 2 a.m. We have these 3 girls with us. We're walking, we're talking to the girls in English. And this guy goes, "Oh, American!" And I go, "Hi." He goes, "Oh, you come here to bang bang." I'm like, "What? You come here porno, yeah, you come here porno." And by the time he said that, 4 of his friends had got out of a car and they jumped us. Because they knew Americans have come to this shithole country to fuck our women. Why else am I there? Why else would I be in Chisinau, Moldova? It's not for all the beautiful girls. They knew exactly why I was there. I knew why I was there. Everyone understood the interaction, and the Moldovan men are just like, "Fuck you." They came, they punched me, I took it, they punched my brother. We got them all on one side because we had them surrounded. We're like, "Okay, we're leaving. My brother speaks Romanian, they speak Romanian and Russian. My brother said, we're not tourists in Romanian. Which threw them off a little bit. And we got in the taxi and we said to the girls, "Come get in the taxi." So the girls still came with us. We got in the taxi. There's his lips bleeding a little bit, nothing too big. We got back to the hotel and went to the hotel. The girls started telling the hotel receptionist what happened. And then what was scary is the hotel receptionist started to panic.
Some level, humans are always going to be racist to some degree. This is how humans function. If I walked down the street and was attacked by a purple man, and then I walked down the street 2 months later and was attacked by a purple man, when I next walk past a purple man, I will be intimidated by said purple man. That's not racism, that's pattern recognition. That's the reason that humans don't try and hug lions, because that we learned a long time ago to recognize patterns. "Hey, did you see Steve? He tried to hug a lion, he ain't got a head anymore. Maybe I should try. Don't be racist."
I'm not fucking him. That's the thing. He drive me where I need to go. He helped me out because I need help, okay? Period. My parents not motherfucking helping me. My mom not helping me. My dad not helping me. My dad in Jamaica. My mom up here. My mom barely can help me. I'm doing everything by my motherfucking self. Damn. I'm 22 years old. I'm doing everything on my own.
Is it seeking arrangements or another site? You talking too much. What are we doing?
Seeking arrangements.
What's the worst way to start your morning?
Breakfast.
Yeah. What, like, I'm actually like with having to eat it, or like just the idea of breakfast?
I think that breakfast is the worst thing that's ever happened to humanity. Ever.
Why?
It's terrible. You're gonna wake up and just eat a bunch of food you haven't had to do any work. You haven't had to hunt for that food, kill that food. You haven't made any money. You've done nothing of conquest, nothing conquest orientated since you've woken up, and you're just gonna sit there and stuff your face.
So you have to earn your meals.
I think so. I think it's undeserved. I think when people wake up and the first thing they do is put food in their mouths, I think it's a bad mental model to approach the day with. I think you should wake up and you should stay hungry. You should stay hungry for a long time. Why not? We ain't gonna die. You can go weeks without food. You should wake up and you should stay hungry for hours and hours and hours until you've made some money or done something of note or been to the gym or progressed in some way so you think, "I deserve some."
You deserve
this. There's not a female on the planet who's invisible today. You can be a 4, overweight, fat. You'll still go to the club and get attention. 99% of the men go to the club and nobody even fucking talks to them. If they try and talk to a girl, they get blanked and ignored and told to Most men are absolutely and utterly invisible. This is the truth about masculinity, right? It's very easy for women to sit here and complain about the top 2% of men because I dealt with this guy, he's arrogant, blah, 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 blah. Most men don't even fucking exist. They send 10,000 DMs and never even get read, let alone replied to. So if you just sit here and say, "I'll get a G, a big G, a boss, a millionaire, and let him have a day off," very nice of you. I'm sure you would. But if you got, if a guy who wanted to have days off all the time, he never would have got important enough in the first place to attract a woman like you. And that is the reality.
Drew, honestly, give me your masseuse's Bitcoin address. I'll send her like 100 grand. She'll never have to do that again.
That would change her life, and I would love to see that.
You have Bitcoin? Bitcoin, you know? You don't have?
I'm going to set you up, because this baller here is going to send you 100 grand. I know he wouldn't lie online.
Can you do that?
Yeah, I'll get someone on it now.
All right, add me on Discord. Add me on Discord. We'll get this done for her. I'm down.
All right, awesome. I'm going to lose my masseuse, but it's fine.
I walk into hell, and the devil's like, oh, I'm going to burn you. You ain't going to do shit.
You're going to burn me? I'll burn you. I'm Andrew Tate. I run shit now. I own hell. The devil's like, oh, shit, yeah, all right, fine. No one's ever stood up to me like you.
And I said, bro, that's what white people do, that shit. I'm too brown for that. I'm not going with the sharks. I just made a joke. There. Oh, no. Cancel me. Who gives a fuck? When I make a statement, maybe you do. Maybe you have all the fucking time in the world to sit on the internet, my friend. But when I make a statement, I don't have time to say, in my personal experience, I don't believe women can drive. However, I understand that some women can drive, and I'm not saying all women can't drive, and I know women who can drive, but in my personal experience, the bad driving I've seen was most likely committed by women. That I don't talk like a fucking geek. I say women can't drive. Now, if that geeks like you, cool, whatever, because geeks, I don't give a fuck. That's what I say. If it upsets people tough, that's my personal experience. You're going to have to get fuck over. That's life.
Just some man, bro. It's a success.
Well, I was offered a fight last minute. I've been retired for 4 years. I only train for fun. I don't train competitively. I smoke cigars. I drink vodka. I'm not living a fighter's life at all. And when I was offered that fight, I was scared. I was nervous. And I was like, I haven't trained, I don't know if I should do it, da, da, da. And I sat there for an hour and I thought, I always viewed myself as a man who's never afraid of physical confrontation. And once I realized I was afraid, it really bothered me. I was like, so that's who I am now? I really didn't like that when I read that text message, the first thing I felt was nerves. I didn't like that at all. So for that reason, I had to say yes. Yeah. Now I have to fight. I don't want to live as a man who believes he was afraid. So I had to say yes. So I went and whooped his ass.
The only reason why most girls hate Andrew Tate is because he's bringing back the strong masculinity to modern society. They only say he's misogynistic because it interferes with their ability to control modern men into doing the things they want them to do. Women are scared to lose their simps on the internet, giving them free attention that is like a drug addiction to them. They're scared to lose their income from all the simps on OnlyFans. And they're scared they cannot get married anymore because they cannot emotionally manipulate weak beta males. It's time to say it as it is. Andrew Tate is one of the most influential humans in modern society.
But my sister has an OnlyFans. What do you think about OnlyFans?
I'm a capitalist, and I believe if there's a product that people will buy, then someone should sell it. I have no problems intrinsically with females doing OnlyFans. Like, if men are stupid enough to buy this shit, then women should certainly sell it and make a bunch of money. More power to them. I'm a feminist. I believe in empowering women. Make as much money as you can. Right. Yeah, sure. Be do OnlyFans. Like my bitch, I wouldn't even mind my girl doing OnlyFans as long as I kept all the money. I wouldn't give a shit. If I had a girl who said I want to do OnlyFans, I'm like, cool, go for it. Let me know how much money we make.
You're keeping all of it, though?
Fuck yes. She's mine.
100%. You're keeping all profits.
I mean, I might let her buy us some shoes or something. But all in all, I mean, it goes into my bank, and I might gift her something, depending if she's been good that month. But she's my property, so she's selling my property, or my chick, or my property. You're going to sell pictures of my property. Cool, where's my money? How much money did we make? My money. Give me my money.
Maybe she should get maybe 50-50.
What? Why? What's wrong with you? On what should she get 50% of my money? Why would I give half my money to her? Mine.
Yeah.
I asked on my TikTok story, do you think I could pick up girls using things that Andrew Tate says? Apparently a good bit of you think I could, so let's see if that's possible.
I could have the most beautiful girlfriend in the world, and the chance of her sleeping with my friend is less than 0%.
That was quite the conversation starter. You typed that out, reread it, and said, yep, that's the one. So as Andrew would say now,
first thing you need to do is you need to get their attention. Once you have their attention, what I personally say, I just want to say you are absolutely beautiful.
She says, thank you, love. Not bad yourself. Hmm.
The only thing she can really say is thank you. Has to say something positive, right? But let's look at this from a human psychology perspective. I'm a stranger, but the first interaction is positive. And I was wondering if I could have your Instagram. The reason I asked for an Instagram...
Surprisingly, it all worked. So yeah, I guess this is what the comment section will call a commentates W. I think that's right.
You don't go in the ocean.
No, fuck no. Swimming pools are nice, crystal clear. I can see in them.
Because he was in there.
I stay in 5-star resorts, my friend. Private. Security.
He's got this, he
bro,
the same
I ain't going in the fucking ocean. No, sir.
No.
Are you scared of the ocean?
No.
Truthfully, are you?
It's not about scared. It's that if a shark, I'm a proud guy. If a shark bites me, I'm going to bite him back.
I personally don't want to sit and sleep with loads of men. I don't care. Like,
good.
I don't
We're getting somewhere. You see, God, Jesus, I'm getting her. Please, little by little, got 2 hours left. Give me some time. I'll fix it.
No, but if I want to, then I'm going to.
Sorry.
The best way-
I don't think the world has ever been equal. But that the modern society we live in has been built by men. Let's cut the crap. All the roads you see, all the buildings you see, everything around you, men built. All of it. When women come along and say, oh, we're just as important, you are just as important. You do had a completely different role. You fulfilled a different role in society. And I think now, if you look at the roles of society, I believe men are still doing their job, but I don't know if women are doing their job. Men are still out here building the modern world. But when they come home now, the girl's like, oh, why should I cook for you? The most push-ups I've ever done in my life was in a jail cell in Stevenage. So without giving too much detail, I get arrested, blah, blah, blah. Innocent, of course. They take me down to the thing. The guy who was checking us in, some fat fuck. Real fat, arrogant police officer bullshit. And I was telling him I shouldn't have been arrested and I was innocent and everything. He goes, well, we don't often make mistakes. Just be to come, checking me and taking my fingerprints, all this crap. And I saw that he had the cameras for the cells in the back. So when I went to my police cell, they gave me some book. Worst book I ever read. Fucking awful. So I'd read 3 pages, 50 push-ups. 3 pages, 50 push-ups. So I did that for like an hour, and then when they took me back out, the fat guy goes, Iron Man, to make fun of me.